And in this case, with his legs, he showed the defense there's an extra dynamic to his game.
So they go from one 42-yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Tackle made at the 38-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
His throw incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And it's third down.
Incomplete. Brings up third down and 6.
On play action, they'll throw. Found his target, it's Anderson. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A good-looking drive so far for the Panthers and a first down here. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, step it back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. 4 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a third down.
It's a gain of 4. Brings up third and 9.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Open man is Samuel, complete.
The pass.
And he is going to be stopped at the 12, short of the first down. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Joey Sly on for the field goal. A 29-yard attempt.
And his kick is good. And the Panthers stay claim to a 3-0 lead.
Panthers 3, Raiders nothing.
Well, all offseason, probably a lot of thought goes into that first drive of week one. They didn't get the touchdown, but at least they got something.
And what I like about it is that they didn't overthink it, because you're exactly right. A lot goes into the offseason, the preseason, to get to that first drive of the regular season. They went right downfield, mission accomplished, points on the board.
Second drive of the game coming up for this Las Vegas offense. They were forced to punt on their initial drive of the new season. Now they're ready to go as they begin again with a first and 10. Throwing now is Carr. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Yetur Gross-Matos in there to drop him, and that will go in the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. Congratulations, young man. After the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Shotgun now for Carr. Catch is made by Hunter Renfrow. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Got a man open, it's Darren Waller. First pass. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Here's A.J. Cole now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. A punt of 46, a return of 5.
The Panthers take over first.
We remind you, lots more to come here in this opening weekend of the Return to Football 2020. Coming up later tonight, it's the national debut of SoFi Stadium in Southern California. The Cowboys and the Rams doing battle there. And then two more to finish off the week on Monday Night Football. The Steelers and Giants from MetLife Stadium and the Titans and Broncos from Mile High. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore.
Complete.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Brings up 2nd and 2.
Now an option play on 2nd down. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Now they face a 2nd and long following the holding penalty. He's got a 1st down and then some at midfield. And finally out of bounds, just a few yards short of the goal line at the 3. A big play there for the Panthers. So that about the shortest pass a quarterback can make, but it winds up going for a bundle.
Yeah, let's face it, in the stats, it sure looks like a heck of a throw, doesn't it? It's almost like in baseball when you get that little Texas leaguer that turns into a double, you would think that you hit it off the wall. Big time play for him on a short little pass.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense gonna have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
From back at the 4, here's 2nd and goal. Another run, this time McCaffrey. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. The 2nd down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there. 2nd quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. A big play if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's 3rd and goal. Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on 3rd and goal. Let's see what they do on 4th and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on 4th and goal. So they've got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
So scores on their first 2 possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
The Vegas offense ready for their next possession. They are still in search of their first points of the ball game, but only down 6-0 as they begin with a 1st down. Carr with a play fake to Jacobs. On the crossing route, complete. That's Williams. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. That's that's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, the stats that matter on this play don't help a team very much, unless, of course, you're playing defense.
If you're getting points per reception, you got a reception, but yeah, no yardage. Great job by the defense, though. They read through that one.
They read through it, gave up no yardage, and people got credit for tackles. Pretty good deal.
Here's A.J. Cole now as he's on to punt for Vegas. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
That's going to be caught by Samuel. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down.
It's on the pickup. It's second and inches at the 21-yard line.
On second down, McCaffrey, and they'll get him down here at the 23. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here to start the new season. So let's take our first trip around the NFL. We get things started with a good one in the NFC. Seattle traveling down south to take on Atlanta at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And it's the Seahawks who have the lead as those two teams approach halftime. Two touchdown passes there for Russell Wilson. From there, we head up to Foxborough to check on the Patriots at home at Gillette Stadium. And that one's gone to the half with them leading the visiting Miami Dolphins. Cam Newton with a couple of touchdown passes there. Lastly, let's check on one final game for you. And they currently trail the visiting Philadelphia Eagles. Carson Wentz with a touchdown pass there. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a defensive struggle. Which offense can break through in the second half? To find out, let's hand it over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. McCaffrey. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 39.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. LaMarcus Joyner with a pick. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
It's now second and six at the 41.
Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 6 yards, the pickup, and that's a first down.
It's a gain of six. First down.
Carr now to throw. And Waller taking it in over the middle. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
Brings up second and one.
On second down, Jacobs. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down. Stopped at the Panthers 37. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10.
I thought when Josh Jacobs was coming at the University of Alabama, he was an absolutely perfect fit for John Gruden's offense with the Raiders, and it turned out, in this case, I was absolutely right. Led the NFL rookies in rushing a year ago, 1,150 yards. In fact, the only rookie to top the 1,000-yard barrier, and this kid is a workhorse who can carry the football in any situation and catch it out of the backfield.
That one, a first down pickup of eight.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
First down, they go with Jacobs again. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
Gain on the play. Second and 10.
Looking to throw on second down. Carr, he's going to find and complete it to Renfro. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of five or six.
Pick up on the play. And it's third down.
From the gun now on third down, Carr. Aguilar has it. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders.
Nelson Aguilar.
A 20-yard touchdown. And the Raiders have drawn even here, and they can take the lead with the extra point to come.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6. That time a 9-play drive, and it winds up in 6 points for the Raiders. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away, is Carlson. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him, but he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
Now the throw pulled in by Anderson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
And they run the option here on first and 10. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37.
Ball carrier.
We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 9 now. He'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The Raider offense now making their way toward the huddle. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it. And the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play.
Throwing on second down. Carr. Incomplete. This a very important drive, and that incompletion leads to a very important third down here if they're going to try and get the football back.
Yeah, getting it back, absolutely crucial to their chances to try and win this game. I would expect a lot of pressure here. They can't afford to let them continue to get first downs and eat away at the clock.
They do get seven out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. But you said it earlier in the quarter when we saw a broken tackle then that we might see some missed tackles here early on in week one, and that's another one right there.
Yeah, not a surprise at all. It will even out as the season extends because everyone will get used to the play speed. But right now, here in the early season, the advantage definitely goes to the offense.
Here's A.J. Cole now as he's on to punt for Las Vegas. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 31.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Catch there by DJ Moore, who's really starting to come into his own. And he's one of that pack of receivers in the NFL now that looks like running backs and plays like that as well when they catch the football. Last year, nearly 1,200 yards receiving, 78 yards per game, and that ranked in the top 10 in the league. Expect those numbers to continue to grow.
Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it and lost it there, and it'll be second down. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They throw again on second down. This one's complete.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
5 yards. Now it's third and five.
Catch there by Robbie Anderson, and we all know he's got the speed to get behind any defense. What I think is underrated about his game is his toughness and his belief in self. Robbie Anderson is an undrafted free agent who's turned into a big-time player in the NFL, and now landing in Carolina reunites him with his college coach, Matt Rhule, when they were together at Temple.
That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Here's McCaffrey. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6. The Panthers got to go quickly. They're moving with a sense of urgency right now. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
So now after the face mask penalty, here's first and goal. Back to throw. And he's got it. And the Panthers are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. They'll try to punch it in with Davis. And the avenue collapsed for him as he's going to be held up short of the goal line. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front.
And that was an impressive drive. But I think we're going to talk about being way more impressive because of who led them. A rookie quarterback in that spot, putting his team in front, that's big league.
So a big play coming for the Panthers. They'll go for two. They'll try and throw for it. And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
So Carr and the Raiders now down 14-7, a little over 80 ticks to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. To throw is Carr. Throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jacobs. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Carr. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
He was covered by Dante Jackson.
They'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by the rookie Jeremy Chinn. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Well, you can see what they were trying to do, just send those guys out there to make a play, but that is a costly interception.
Yeah, that's kind of like the backyard. Everybody go deep, and let's see if we can find someone. Four verticals in the route. Any other time in the game, I love the call. But here, you're not going to hold safeties, you're not going to hold corners with any looks because they know what the situation is, ends up throwing the interception.
The Carolina offense about ready to go. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. And they take a knee.
I do get a kick out of seeing a team kneel down at the end of the game in victory formation and wrap one up, because most of the time a kneel down is not a good thing in football. In this case, it's the best thing for the team that's winning.
Best thing week one, and 1-0 after going down to that knee. So this one is over, a victory for Carolina. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books, going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us, all these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for Carolina, it was a hard-fought game, and they'll exit 1-0 as they win by a touchdown. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Meanwhile, for Las Vegas, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the New Orleans Saints. The players on your team quickly upgrade your team at the end of each game.
He's a bozo. Bozo. Really?
Yeah. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah. I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up. Did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the world suspended. I told them.
What I told them.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was pop, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10, 10 since. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who is the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the
what?
I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the
what?
You in the way. Either you rolling the dust. You better support.
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the That's wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
Won't you get down?